3, 2, 1.
Listen up, y'all, cause this is it. The beat that I'm banging is delicious.
So delicious. It's my high. So delicious.
Welcome to the first day of Lent. Lent is the time of the year in which people sacrifice. Sacrificing means giving up your biggest desire for the sake of other considerations. Lent starts today, which is Ash Wednesday, and ends on Easter Sunday. Each of you will be given an ash to remember that you're made of code. And to code, you shall return.
Well, it's finally the time we gave up our bad habits. I'm gonna give up watching TV for Lent. What will you give up, Candlehead?
I'll give up staying up late.
Great sacrifice, Candlehead. How about you, Taffyta? What's your sacrifice?
Actually, I'm not sacrificing anything this year.
Well, you gotta sacrifice something, Taffyta. Lent is about giving up things for the sake of strength. Why don't you give up your obsession of sugary sweets for Lent?
Rancis, please don't talk me into giving up that.
But you just finished your ABC sweets 2 days ago, all the way from A to Z. So you should really give up sugary sweets because you don't want to eat too much.
I am not willing to accept it, Rancis. I am the queen of sugary sweets, and I eat what I want to eat. There is no way I am sacrificing on sugary sweets.
I don't speak to Winchell and Duncan.
Taffyta, do you really want to get sick again? I would not, but I would also not stop with the sugary sweets. And if I eat ABC sweets, I'm gonna eat 1, 2, 3 sweets too.
I want you to do me a favor, guys. I'd like you to be Taffyta's guardians and make sure she doesn't eat any sugary sweets until Easter.
Oh, you know, that's ridiculous, Sour Bill.
Taffyta loves sugary sweets. Why would we make a policy to not allow it?
Well, today's Ash Wednesday, and Taffyta does not want to give up on sweets, but she should give up on it for Lent.
Well, then if we were you, we would take that policy into consideration.
Good idea. We can also help Taffyta become more fit.
Good going, guys.
I always get so hungry for food, I must feel like a pig. But I'm not sure what to eat. I guess I'll just look in my fridge. So I have some sugar-free strawberry jello and chocolate chip cookie dough, and I'm gonna have the Hershey s'mores pudding. Hershey s'mores pudding is delicious. I'm gonna open this box and eat all 4 of these cups. Oh, someone's at the door. Oh, hi, donut cops. Come on in.
Guess what, Taffyta? We're gonna be your guardians for the whole Lent this year.
You wanna stay with me for 6.5 weeks?
Of course we do. What do you think of that?
That would be fine with me, especially keeping company. I'm gonna have some Hershey s'mores pudding in the kitchen.
Well, actually, Taffyta, we're here to make sure you don't eat any sugary sweets until Easter.
Sour Bill has made us set up a new policy for Lent this year.
Does this mean I'm not allowed to eat any sugary sweets until the 9th of April?
100% that is Taffyta.
Can I still eat starch?
Of course you can.
What about dairy foods?
You can have those too.
What about juice?
Juice is fine.
And meat?
Meat is fine too.
Except on Good Friday.
All that you can't eat during Lent is sugary sweets, but you can eat any other type of food there is.
Fine, whatever.
We're watching you, Taffyta.
Wow, we're going on a cruise for Holy Week.
Hey, Sour Bill.
Yes, Taffyta.
I haven't eaten any sugary sweets for 37 days. All because I'm under authority of those stupid donut cops.
That's right, but don't you call the cops stupid. It's not nice to call them that.
I don't care how rude it is, Sour Bill. Every time I try to take a sugary sweet, the cops always snatch it from me.
You don't seem to be able to get used to this. You'd turn into a big piece of candy if you kept up with your sugary sleeps. In fact, you must have lost some weight on you, Taffyta.
Taffyta, I've got some news to tell you.
What is the news? And is it any good?
Well, the Litwak's arcade is closed for the entire Holy Week, and Mr. Litwak is on vacation with his family in Galveston, Texas. We're going for a week on the Disney Wonder cruise ship tomorrow.
You excited, Taffyta?
Actually, I don't go on cruise ships.
Well, you're going on this cruise ship with us. It's still Lent and we need to stay with you so we can make sure you don't eat any sugary sweets until Easter. So you are going on this cruise with us.
I would not trust a cruise ship. It's a vacation in which you stay in one place all week out in the middle of the ocean, and you can't get off of it when not on land. And if it ever encounters a big storm, it will bounce up and down in the waves and cause damage everywhere. There is no way I would ever encourage cruising on vacation.
Taffyta, you can say a cruise is not what you want, but you are going on the Disney Wonder, and that's final. And don't worry about any bad storms out there, because if one ever comes, I'm sure the ship will avoid the storm and take a different route.
Well, I'll try to trust you. What about Rancis and Candlehead?
All us residents of Sugar Rush are going on the cruise, except Lord Jubilina and Crumbelina.
I never noticed before that Jubilina and Crumbelina rhyme with each other. You'll stay here and take care of Pupper while I'm on vacation, right, Crumbelina? Yeah, I will. Great. Just like the last time you did when I went to New York back in December. I'll go out and walk the dog.
Candlehead, can you believe we're going on a cruise tomorrow? I've waited years to go on one.
Me too. I've been dreaming of that as well.
You know, I've always had this on my bucket list ever since we both watched Alvin and the Chipmunks 3 Chipwrecked in the movie theater a long time ago.
So that must be 11 years you've dreamt of cruising.
Alright, I'm gonna go home and pack my stuff.
I'll pack my stuff too, Rancis. I should be doing some packing for the cruise tomorrow, but my body feels too tired to do it. You know what? I can save the packing for tomorrow morning before we leave for the cruise. I'll get a water bottle instead for tonight. I'll take this one. Good night, Winchell and Duncan, wherever you went out to.
Duncan, I can't believe we had to come back here in our home castle to pack our stuff for the cruise tomorrow.
Well, then why didn't you think of packing for Taffyta's house in the first place when we were gonna watch Taffyta?
I don't know, but let's go back to Taffyta's house and get some rest.
Winchell, I'd rather sleep here tonight. We've been sleeping at Taffyta's every night since the start of Lent, and I've been feeling homesick.
But what if Taffyta accidentally sleeps too late and misses the cruise and then sneaks on sugary sweets during Lent without us knowing?
Oh, she knows now that she won't eat sugary sweets during Lent. She wouldn't oversleep nor miss the cruise either. She knows what she's doing. She's all good to herself.
Fine. We'll sleep here tonight. I guess our nights of sleeping with Taffyta are over.
Rancis, isn't Taffyta coming with us?
Of course she is, Candlehead. She might be running a bit late, because sometimes she takes a while to pack. I'm sure she'll take another bus and get to the cruise on time.
But it's 1 o'clock and it's a 2-hour ride to San Diego cruise port.
Well, maybe she can take a taxi.
Oh yeah, taxi. I hope it don't cost too much, though.
Sorry we took a while, guys.
We had some trouble trying to fit our stuff in the luggage.
Well, glad you finally come, guys.
The bus is here.
Where have Winchell and Duncan went? They're gone. Oh no, they left me behind from the Disney Wonder Cruise. Which means I don't have to go on it. Well, I must be lucky to not make it to the cruise. I would not want a vacation like that. Hey, with the cops not watching me, I'm gonna sneak on 1, 2, 3 sweets while they're out on vacation. They'll never even know I'm doing it. I'm gonna start with this Oreo milkshake. It's the most delicious food at McDonald's. And since one is the first number in counting, I chose one Oreo milkshake. I just finished my milkshake. I'm thinking of going up to 20. Kids love to count up to that number.
What would you like today?
Two chocolate cupcakes.
Those will be $11.98.
Next sugary sweet, two chocolate cupcakes. I'm gonna go buy more sweets in the supermarket.
Whoa, that's a really huge ship. It looks bigger than a shopping mall.
That's because it's a cruise ship, Rancis. Cruises are supposed to be gigantic floating hotels. I'd rather call it a resort instead. Hey, how come Swizzle's not viewing the boat?
Because I'm not looking forward to this vacation. That sail and hotel will look nothing like Sugar Rush.
Well, maybe they'll have a candy shop inside. I wonder if Taffyta got on the boat already.
Guys, what are you waiting for? We gotta get on the cruise now.
Yeah, come on, racers. You don't want to be late.
All right, we're coming. Candlehead, I've never been on a boat like this before.
Me neither, Rancis. It doesn't feel like we're on a boat. It feels like we're in a building.
Well, technically it is a building, but a floating one. Even though it's got 11 floors, or decks as you would call them on a cruise ship.
Excuse me, have you seen Taffyta at all today?
No, but she might have just went straight to her cabin and took a nap.
Okay then.
Come on, let's go check out her cabin.
Oh boy! I picked up a lot of stuff from the supermarket. I can't wait to have so many sweets this week. I feel too tired to do all the emptying of these packages. I want to give myself a rest.
I can't believe we get to sleep on a boat for spring vacation. It's like you're being carried away in your dream when in bed.
That's wonderful. Hey, I heard there are supposed to be 3 ports of call in Mexico during the cruise. We're scheduled to be in Puerto Vallarta on Tuesday, then on Wednesday in Cabo San Lucas, and on Friday in Ensenada.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome aboard the Disney Wonder. We will be setting sail in 5 minutes. We hope you enjoy your cruise. Thank you.
Finally!
I'm gonna have my first nap on a boat. I'll sleep on the bed and you can sleep on the couch.
That's actually what I've been thinking of. I'm coming. Hey there, Taffyta here.
Guess what today is, Taffyta? It's my birthday. Me and Gloyd are celebrating at my house with cherry pie, and you are invited to my house.
Okay, Jubilina, I'll come on over. Jubilina, I haven't come on over to celebrate your birthday in like 5 years or so.
Well, I really missed you coming on over.
I miss coming to your house too. I really like the renovations inside.
I like the renovations too. Excuse you, Taffyta. Why are you eating the pie when we have not sung the happy birthday song yet?
Because I was too hungry to wait to eat, and I'm eating 3 slices of cherry pie.
Well, you can't have more than 3 slices, Taffyta. That's too much. 1 or 2 is plenty.
Actually, I've just finished eating the 3 slices. But don't tell Duncan or Winchell I ate this. It's still Lent.
I'm still mad that you ate your cherry pie slices without us singing happy birthday first.
Well, I'll sing Jubilina a birthday song and then you can have your cherry pie slices.
Celebrate your birthday, Jubilina!
Alright, song's done. You can have your pie while I use the bathroom.
Yay! She finally sung a birthday song.
Great song!
Look out there, Candlehead. You can get a beautiful view of the ocean.
Yeah, it's very beautiful, and so blue. Especially when you view from this deck.
I agree. You get a better view when you're on a higher deck of the ship.
I wonder why they call this restaurant Pinocchio's Pizzeria.
Well, it's a Disney-themed vacation ship, a floating Disney World. And the stuff is supposed to be based on Disney-related content. Like, this restaurant and its name are based on the Disney film Pinocchio. Which means that we're not allowed to tell lies here or our noses would grow long. I'm just joking. Go ahead and tell a lie if you want.
Well, since you lied, your nose is actually growing.
Good lie, Candlehead. I mean, Good joke, Candlehead. You want to go to the Oceaneer Club after we finish our pizza? Minty and Adorabeezle are hosting a quiz about the Toy Story franchise.
Great idea, Rancis. I love the Toy Story movies.
I love them, too.
Taffyta, does this song sound familiar to you?
I never even heard it before. What's it called?
You never heard it before? That's odd.
Almost every Sugar Rush racer knows this song. This is actually my favorite song of all time. It is called Cherry.
Well, then I wish this song played while I was eating my cherry pie. I am now eating 4 graham crackers.
Graham crackers. I wish we had a graham cracker-themed racer in Sugar Rush.
I'm gonna start heading home. Well, see you soon.
So, Rancis, Candlehead, are you ready for the Toy Story quiz?
As soon as you are, Minty.
Great. We're going to have some fun with this quiz. We have 10 questions about the Toy Story movies. We're going to go in order of the 4 Toy Story films and the events that happen in them. We're going to start with the first film. Okay, so the first question. What toy does Andy get as his favorite birthday present?
My first guess would be the Battleship board game.
No way, Rancis. Andy literally loved Buzz Lightyear the most, even more than Woody. Good guesses. Second question. What restaurant did Buzz mistake for a spaceport?
You haven't revealed the correct answer for the first question yet.
We'll reveal the correct answers at the end of the quiz, so don't worry about that for now.
Well, then I would say a Chuck E. Cheese restaurant as my guess for this question.
That's not even close to being space-themed. It's Pizza Planet, which reminds me, I wish we actually had a Pizza Planet here on this ship.
I was hoping they would have one, but unfortunately they don't. But at least they have a Toy Story world like this. It's kind of like Andy's room.
All right, let's not go off topic. We're gonna move on to the next question. Third question. How did Woody save Buzz from being blown up by Sid?
I'm sure Woody detached Buzz from the rocket.
No, Woody and Sid's toys came to life in front of Sid and scared him away. Great guessing. Now we're gonna move on to the second Toy Story film. So the fourth question. Who stole Woody and took him to his apartment?
Well, I would say Stinky Pete the Prospector.
No, it was Al. He's the guy that took Woody and added him to his Woody's Roundup collection. You really are good at guessing, Candlehead. Fifth question. Why did Woody decide to go to Japan with the Roundup gang before changing his mind to go back to Andy?
Probably because he wanted to see what Tokyo was like.
Not exactly, Rancis. Prospector talked him into going to Japan to stay with the Roundup gang. Well, this wraps up our questions about the second Toy Story film. Now we're gonna move on to Toy Story 3. Now the sixth question. Who donated Andy's toys to Sunnyside Daycare by mistake?
I would say Andy himself.
Obviously, it was his mom who did that. Seventh question. Who tried to prevent Andy's toys from leaving Sunnyside Daycare?
Once again, I'm guessing Andy.
No, it was Lotso Huckinbear. Eighth question. Who does Andy give his toys to at the end of Toy Story 3?
Molly.
Bunny, you're doing great on this quiz. Our last two questions will be about Toy Story 4. Ninth question. What toy does Bonnie make in kindergarten orientation?
A lunchbox?
No, the lunchbox isn't a toy. It's Forky. We've got one more question to go. 10th question. Who is the girlfriend of Woody in which he eventually reunites with?
I'm guessing Jessie.
Francis, Woody and Jessie are just friends. Bo Peep is Woody's girlfriend. Are you ready for the answers? Well, let's reveal them. Hooray! I got all my answers correct.
Seriously? All my answers are wrong? I was so bad on this quiz.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the captain speaking. Just to let you know that we will be arriving in Cabo San Lucas tomorrow. We will not be sailing to Puerto Vallarta due to a bad storm going on there. Instead, once again, we will be in Cabo San Lucas tomorrow, then on Wednesday in Ensenada, then on Thursday back in San Diego. So I'm sorry the cruise is a little shorter than originally planned. We just don't want to be caught in bad weather, so the cruise will be 5 nights instead of 7. So we hope you understand, and we hope you still enjoy the cruise despite the change in schedule. Thank you.
Good morning, Strawberry Girl. Welcome to Dunkin' Donuts. What would you like for breakfast today?
For breakfast, I would like to have 5 donuts.
You sure you want to have that many?
Sir, I haven't gotten sick for over a month, even after eating 3 buttered bagels.
Then why don't you have a bagel instead?
I'd rather have 5 donuts for today's breakfast.
Well, then that would be $9.95.
I'm eating 5 donuts for breakfast today. Francis, why are you kneeling in your bed and crying?
Because we can't go to Puerto Vallarta due to a storm, and I really want to see it.
And we're only cruising for 5 nights, not 7.
Oh, come on, Rancis. Just because the cruise is short, it doesn't mean you can't have fun. We're going to be arriving in Cabo San Lucas any second now. You're definitely going to enjoy Cabo San Lucas, Rancis.
But what if the time goes too fast on our cruise? And what if I keep thinking about Puerto Vallarta?
Rancis, why don't you just forget it? I'm not really interested in Puerto Vallarta. I'm more interested in Cabo San Lucas, and I'm looking forward to seeing it.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the captain speaking. Just to let you know, we have just arrived at Cabo San Lucas in Mexico. The gangway is now open. We will be parked here until 6 o'clock p.m. So if you want, feel free to exit the ship and explore Cabo San Lucas. But please be back before 6 p.m. so you don't miss the rest of the cruise. Thank you.
Oh boy, Cabo San Lucas. Come on, Rancis, let's explore.
All right.
I'm not sure what to do today. I just had 5 donuts, and now what should I have 6 of? Oh, hello, Twin Taffyta. Good to see you. Actually, I don't call myself Twin Taffyta anymore. I now call myself Taffyta number 2. And speaking of 2, my friends call me that new name, 2. Well, then from now on, I'll call myself Taffyta number 1, instead of just Taffyta. Good idea. People won't be confused then. You know, my father set up a special scavenger hunt in the cornfield maze game. You're invited to look for 6 strawberry shortcakes. Mmm, strawberry shortcakes. I can't wait to eat them. Actually, they're not to be eaten. What do you mean I can't eat them? Well, you're only invited to bring me back the strawberry shortcakes so I can use them to decorate the stage in the arcade theater for an upcoming play. What play is it? Do you really want to know what it is? Of course I do. I want to see if it sounds interesting. Okay, I'll tell you. The play is called Lost in Strawberry Shortcake World. I will be playing the main character, Miss Strawberries, who in the story gets separated from her mother and tries to look for her, but winds up stuck in a world of strawberry shortcakes. That doesn't sound like an interesting story. Well, you could have not asked me to tell you about it in the first place then. Come on, let's just go to Cornfield Maze and do the scavenger hunt. So, Taffyta number 1, all you're gonna do is walk around this maze and look for 6 strawberry shortcakes, but don't eat them. Bring them back to me so I can use them to finish decorating the stage. You got it, Twin Taffyta. I mean, Taffyta number 2. Here are a couple strawberry shortcakes. I am going to eat all 6 of them. 6 strawberry shortcakes. That's 2 strawberry shortcakes, 4 more to go. Wow, more strawberry shortcakes to eat. The last 2 strawberry shortcakes. Boy, I hope Taffyta number 1 doesn't take too long looking for those strawberry shortcakes. Alright, Taffyta number 2, I'm back. You couldn't find any of the strawberry shortcakes? Actually, I ate them all.
You did?
I mean, yes, I could not find them.
Don't you dare lie to me like that, Taffyta number 1. I am not happy with you. You are not supposed to eat those strawberry shortcakes. And thanks to that, now I'm gonna have to do the play without those strawberry shortcakes. Goodbye!
Wasn't that a fun quiz we did yesterday, Adorabeezle? Yeah, it was a fun Toy Story quiz. I like the question about the toy saving Buzz by coming to life and scaring Sid in the first Toy Story movie the best. My favorite was the question in which Buzz thought Pizza Planet was a spaceport.
Girls, I want to go home.
Swizzle, you don't like the Disney Wonder Cruise?
I hate it. It's even worse than Boston.
Well, you can't get off the ship right now. Actually, you can. We're docked at Cabo San Lucas, and we have till 6 o'clock to explore it.
I'm not even exploring that city. Tell the captain to turn the boat around and sail straight back to San Diego.
Swizzle, we won't be leaving Cabo San Lucas till 6 p.m. And we're gonna make another stop in Ensenada on the way back. Cruise ships and ports of call are supposed to be entertaining recreation, not the world of boredom.
Well, then I should have taken the Sugar Rush cruise, the one based entirely on Sugar Rush that sails to a candy-coated private island.
Look at all the boats, Rancis. This dock is amazing.
It sure is, Candlehead.
I'm gonna count the boats and see how many there are. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7,
Candlehead?
8, 9,
I think
10,
there are too many
11,
boats to count.
12, 13, 14, 15. I see 15 boats.
There's actually more than that, Candlehead.
Yeah, I guess you're right, Rancis.
Hey, Mr. Marlin, we're Candlehead and Rancis from Sugar Rush. We're exploring Cabo San Lucas. You want to take a picture of us?
Candlehead, it's just a sculpture. It's not sentient.
You want to buy something here in the city?
Okay.
Do you want to buy one of these surfboards, Rancis?
I don't do surfing anymore, and I think those surfboards are only for display.
Oh, you can get back into surfing, Rancis. I got back into doing it last year, and it was fun.
That was actually 2 years ago, and I want to shop for something else.
Well, they have shops back on the cruise. You want to get back on the ship?
Okay. Ooh, I'm going to buy one of these cups.
I'm going to buy a Minnie Mouse cap. I can't wait to try this new hat on. I'm going to truly look like a Disney cruise vacation girl.
And I'm looking forward to using this cup as a way to look back on my memories of this cruise.
I unwittingly told Taffyta number 2 that I ate her strawberry shortcakes yesterday when I was on my scavenger hunt. She better not tell the donut cops I ate them during Lent. Now I'm in big trouble. I'll try to get my mind off of this by eating Pop-Tarts. I'm gonna have 7 s'mores Pop-Tarts for this morning's breakfast. Hey there, Taffyta here.
Taffyta, do you want to come to the Cotton Candy Award Show? It's in the Arcade Theater. Just be there by noon. Me and Jubilina will be there.
Okay, Gloyd, I'll be there in a jiffy.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your Cotton Candy Award Show host, Mr. Arcade Clown.
Greetings, and welcome to the 6th Annual Cotton Candy Award Show of 2023. Today, I, the Arcade Clown, will be giving out 2 cotton candy sticks to each of 4 of the most talented circus animals. Now, before we get started, just to let you know that I will not be doing an opening musical number because that will make this show too long. I know you may be disappointed, but it is what it is.
Oh, that's very sad.
Alright, so let's get to the first award. The first 2 cotton candy sticks go to a large cat-like animal that sleeps 20 hours a day. He also serves as the king of the circus animals. And the Cotton Candy Awards go to...
You know, I always misremember this animal for the tiger.
Well, it can't be the tiger. Perhaps the jaguar?
Obviously the lion.
The lion!
I got it right.
I knew I would be wrong on this.
Okay, let's bring the lion in so he can come here and accept his Cotton Candy Awards.
I don't think the lion's coming.
Well, I just forgot that he is stuck in a deep sleep. He can't make it to this show. I guess I'll just put these on the floor for safekeeping. Now, the next awards go to a gigantic gray animal with big ears and big white horns, with the ability to spin a ring with his big long nose. And those awards go to...
Definitely not an opossum, or even an anteater.
There's no other animal with all those looks like that but the elephant.
The elephant! Alright, Elephant, why don't you come here and accept your Cotton Candy Awards?
If it's here?
Actually, there's something else I forgot. The elephant is getting old, and he's just too clumsy to walk all the way over here. So I'll just put these cotton candy sticks down on the floor for safekeeping.
Why don't you put them on one of those tables instead?
Excuse me, Cherry Girl, but there are 8 billion people on this earth, and only one person is in charge of the Cotton Candy Awards, and that is me, not you.
Sorry. I just thought it would be better on the table.
Once again, you're not in charge of these. Okay, moving on. The next awards go to this fish-eating animal with flippers, and he has a special ability to bounce a ball up and down on top of his nose. And the awards go to...
I suppose it's a whale.
My guess is a dolphin.
The only animal that I've seen bounce a ball on its nose is the seal.
The seal.
I'm super great on guessing, especially when it comes to animals.
No, I don't think the seal is here to come and get his cotton candy warts. But don't ask me why he's not here, I have no clue. I'll put these on the floor for safekeeping. Okay, the last 2 cotton candy warts go to an extremely talented man who tells jokes, juggles balls, blows up balloons, and gives out lots of presents. It's not an animal, by the way.
Well then, what could it be?
It's me, Mr. Arcade Clown. I'm glad to be here to accept my Cotton Candy Awards because they will always have a place inside my heart.
I can't believe you actually have your own award, Mr. Arcade Clown.
Yes, I do. Now, I will be right back and run to the restroom. Be sure to keep an eye on these and make sure nobody eats them.
Don't tell anyone I'm eating all 8 cotton candy sticks.
Okay, we won't. Let's go, Jubilina.
Okay, Gloid.
Alright, I'm back again, guys. Hey, where did everybody go? And who ate all 8 cotton candy awards? Well, this wraps up everything then.
Oh, Vanellope. It's so you. But you have to back out of the race. Yeah.
I think we are in this movie.
Of course we are, Sour Bill. We saw ourselves earlier in this film.
Yeah, I'm definitely racing.
Yeah, well, King Candy says glitches can't race.
I think we left Taffyta behind.
Okay? The rules are there for a reason, Vanellope. To protect us. Say I'm you. I'm in my weird little car, and I'm driving, and I actually feel kind of cool for once. And then all of a sudden, oh no, I'm glitching! Hey, see? You're an accident just waiting to happen. Oh,
no. Well, Taffyta was mean back then.
Cool.
You're breaking.
We gotta call Taffyta right now.
I just want to race like you guys.
What a good award show I went to today.
Hello?
Taffyta, where are you?
I'm in the Litwak arcade in Los Arboretos, California. I just got back home.
Well, Taffyta, we're coming home straight to you. I think we left you behind from our cruise by mistake. We hope you're not eating any sweets.
I'm not. I'm actually great by myself here. Nothing bad would ever happen to me. You can continue with your cruise.
Well, our stop at Puerto Vallarta that was supposed to be today was canceled because of bad weather there, and we ended up stopping at Cabo San Lucas yesterday.
And we're also canceling tomorrow's planned stop at Ensenada. We're gonna tell the captain to sail straight back to California nonstop. We should be there tomorrow night. And we hope you're not lying about not eating any sweets.
I'm not even lying 1%. It's still Lent, by the way.
Okay, we'll try to trust you.
Oh no, I'll have to hurry and finish my 1, 2, 3 sweets and get up to 20 before tomorrow night, or the cops will get me in trouble. I've only made it up to 8 right now.
So, Swizzle, you want to get some ice cream? The treats are based on Monsters, Inc.
You know, I'd rather buy some candy from Vanellope Sweets and Treats instead. It's supposed to resemble our game Sugar Rush. I've been trying to find it, but I didn't see it anywhere in this ship. Maybe they removed it.
Okay, Swizzle, but Vanellope Sweets and Treats is on a different Disney cruise ship. It's not on this cruise ship that we're on now.
Is there really more than one Disney-themed cruise ship? How many are there anyway? And what cruise ship is the Vanellope Sweets and Treats located?
It's the Disney Dream Cruise Ship. And there are 5 Disney-themed cruise ships owned by Disney Cruise Line. There's the Disney Magic, the Disney Wonder, which we're sailing on right now, the Disney Dream, the Disney Fantasy, and the Disney Wish. And Swizzle, let's just get some ice cream here on the ship. I don't want you to feel homesick or sugar rush sick, but ice cream is sugary, by the way, and the treats are as scary as Monsters, Inc. And I know you like Monsters Incorporated, so you might even like these ice cream treats inspired by the film.
All right, fine. I'll have a Monsters Incorporated ice cream.
I'll have one too. I love ice cream almost as much as I love Monsters Incorporated. I'm glad you've come to see us, Candlehead. We're having a great cruise so far. Except Swizzle always gets homesick when on vacation. He wishes the Vanellope Sweets and Treats were on this cruise ship so he can feel at home while cruising. Well, I'll ask the donut cops if they can plan the Disney Dream next time we go on a cruise so Swizzle can see the Vanellope Sweets and Treats. Good idea. But I'm looking forward to seeing Ensenada tomorrow.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the captain speaking. Just to let you know that we're canceling another port of call on this cruise. We will not be visiting Ensenada tomorrow. Instead, we will just be sailing straight right back to San Diego. The reason why we're sailing straight back to San Diego nonstop is because someone told me that they accidentally left a strawberry-headed girl from the ship back in Los Arboritos, and they want to make sure that she's perfectly fine. So once again, our cruise is shortened to 4 nights. Well, actually still 5 nights, but the 5th night, which is tomorrow night at 12:45 a.m., we will be back in San Diego. So we kindly ask that you stay up through 12:45 a.m. tomorrow night so you can exit the ship as soon as we dock back in San Diego cruise port. So we do apologize for the cancellation of our port of call in Ensenada, but we're hoping that you're still enjoying your time on sail vacation. We also do apologize the cruise is shorter, but don't let the time go too fast, and we hope you enjoy the rest of the cruise. Thank you.
I gotta go tell Rancis this. I hope he heard the captain.
Seriously? You shortened the cruise again? And we're not going to Ensenada? Oh, please, Captain, tell me you're joking. Now I can't see what Ensenada's like.
Rancis, did you hear the news from the captain? We're not going to Ensenada tomorrow.
Yes, I did hear the captain. And we have to get off the boat in the midnight hour tomorrow night back in San Diego. I am so upset.
I thought you were so excited about cruising, Rancis. Now you look so down.
Well, I do still like cruising, but I still want to go to Ensenada.
I might want to go there too, but we have to sail straight back to California because we left Taffyta behind from our cruise by mistake. I'm sure the donut cops told the captain to sail back to California nonstop. I'm gonna try to get up to 20 on 1-2-3 sweets without getting sick before the donut cops get back tonight. 9 cups of strawberry milk. Ten chocolate chip cookies. 11 Rice Krispies treats. 10 Taffyta. What should I have 12 of?
Oh no.
I don't think I should have had that many sweets at once. I think I may have to stop with my 1-2-3 sweets and wait till Easter Sunday and then continue. Winchell and Duncan are coming back here tonight. Yeah, I don't think rushing all the way up to number 20 on 1-2-3 sweets within today would be a good idea. It can make me sick.
Wow, I never thought the captain would actually agree to sail straight back to California. He must really understand why we can't cruise without Taffyta.
Yeah, most cruise captains would rather keep their planned ports of call, even if someone told them that someone else got left behind.
It wouldn't be fair for us if the captain refused to cancel our port of call in Ensenada.
Yeah, we really want to get back to Taffyta right now. She said she isn't snacking on any sweets and I hope it's not a lie.
Me too. Otherwise she might get sick and pass out.
Guards, there's gonna be a fireworks show on deck tonight just to let you know.
Really? The captain didn't even announce?
Of course, really. Why would I lie to you?
Well, it must be good news. Makes it like 4th of July.
I actually never saw any fireworks on Independence Day of last year.
Really?
Hey Rancis, what do you think of me wearing this Disney cap? Does it look cool?
Candlehead, that hat actually looks too big to fit you. You'd probably go with a Sugar Rush racer-sized Disney cruise vacation hat instead.
You know what, Rancis? You're right. I actually don't like this cap anyway. It's more for a regular person than a Sugar Rush racer like me. Rancis, are you excited for tonight's fireworks? They're gonna be on the top deck of the ship.
Which deck?
Deck 10.
Actually, deck 11 is the top deck.
I guess you're right, Rancis. But Deck 11 is actually much smaller compared to the other decks on the ship. But Deck 10 is where we're watching the fireworks. I can't wait to see them tonight. It's a great way to end the cruise.
Yeah, it's the end of the cruise after all. I feel like this vacation went too fast. It feels to me like yesterday we just started our cruise vacation.
Rancis, let's make this final night a great ending to our cruise. We're gonna see a gorgeous display of fireworks in the sky tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the captain speaking. Just a quick announcement that our fireworks show tonight is canceled because we could not find any matches to light the fireworks, so there will be no fireworks show tonight. So we hope you bear with us on this cancellation, and we will be arriving back in San Diego at 12:45 a.m. Thank you.
Oh, that's bad news, Rancis. No fireworks on a Disney cruise.
Well, we can try something else, Candlehead. We can put on a play in the theater and even have a light show in the play. Maybe Taffyta would be interested in seeing it.
That should be better than nothing, Rancis. And actually, Taffyta got left behind by mistake. We're vacationing without Taffyta.
Oh yeah, I forgot. Taffyta did not come with us on the Disney Wonder. I can't believe we forgot Taffyta. She's back home in Los Arboritos. She's our leader of the Sugar Rush Racers. She's important to our cruise, and she's not cruising with us.
Eat it.
12 chocolate bars.
It's the same bar. It's just a little slower on the journey, that's all.
Perhaps from now on till Easter, I will only eat sugary sweets when the doughnut cops are not around.
Also, I have not left this house all day today.
You're sitting at home watching television, and suddenly a commercial.
Man, I can't believe it took hours to make this play.
Yeah, a little longer than expected. So I be the princess.
And I be the pirate. And Minty will be the narrator of this play.
That's right. I'm narrating the princess and the pirate. Come on, Rancis, let's go to the backstage.
Well, Adorabeezle, after this show ends, it'll be about time we leave the cruise in San Diego. After 5 days of sailing, I'm ready for this cruise to end. How about you?
I wish our planned 7-day sailing didn't change, Swizzle. You never enjoy vacations when we're not in Sugar Rush.
I would only enjoy it if we went on the Disney Dream. Because like you said, Adorabeezle, that's the ship that holds Vanellope sweets and treats, which is just like Sugar Rush. Other than that, I don't like vacations.
I didn't like this vacation either. I didn't like sailing for days. And I didn't do much on this cruise ship. I mostly stayed in my cabin laying in my bed.
It's time for The Princess and the Pirate.
Welcome to the Walt Disney Theater. I am Minty Zaki, and I am going to narrate a play called The Princess and the Pirate. It's about a young princess who can't find anything to put on a lights display and needs help from a pirate. Once upon a time, there was a lovely young princess who lived in a big castle. She loved her castle so much that she couldn't take her mind off of it. What a beautiful castle. I can't even think of any better place to live. I might put on a lights display inside, but I don't know what to use. I might need some help from someone. One day, the princess decided to put on a lights display in her castle, but she did not know what to use. Then suddenly, a handsome young pirate came along.
Can I help you with something, princess?
Yes, I need you to help me find something to put on a lights display. Do you know what I can use?
Come with me, princess. I'll take you to my pirate ship.
So the pirate took the princess to his pirate ship. They brought back strings of lights to the castle.
So, princess, how do you like these lights?
They're beautiful. I love them. Thanks, pirate.
You're welcome, princess.
The princess and the pirate stared at the lights with joy. And that day couldn't have been any better. The end.
That was great acting in the play being the pirate.
And I was an awesome princess actor. I even loved hearing Minty's narration.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have just docked back in San Diego. The gangway is now open. All passengers may disembark from the ship. If you haven't packed yet, please pack your belongings and then head to the gangway on deck 1. Thank you. We hope you enjoyed your cruise, and we hope to see you again soon.
Let's go back to the cabin and get packing.
I'll miss you, Disney Wonder. I wish Taffyta joined us on this cruise.
Come on, Candlehead, we gotta get back to the cabin and pack so we can leave. We don't want anything left behind.
I wonder if Crumbelina has got back home yet. She always stays at Candlehead's house and takes care of Popper when Candlehead is away. Crumbelina must still not be home. She must still be taking care of Popper, even though Candlehead came home last night. Wow, she left her 13 caramel cookies by mistake when she left. I guess I'll just take a bite of one of them. It's crazy that I've made it up to 13 already. I'm at like 2/3 of 20 into 1, 2, 3 sweets. Wait, I said I would only have one of Crumbelina's caramel cookies. I ate all 13 of them, and Duncan and Windchill have just got back home last night.
So Windchill, how was our first night sleeping back here again since we left for our cruise?
Well, it was good, Duncan, but we should go check up on Taffyta and get back with her.
Uh-oh, did we forget to do that last night?
Let's go to Taffyta's house.
Isn't it great to be back in Sugar Rush after 5 days of sail in the Pacific Ocean?
Well, it is, but I really miss the cruise so much. And its original 7-day plan should have remained. And we did not get to see Puerto Vallarta or Ensenada.
Rancis, I don't care about schedule changes.
But I do. And you like vacations.
I do, but I always feel like the next fresh new chapter of our home when we return from vacation.
Well, I guess I'll agree with you then. Why don't we go to Taffyta's house, Candlehead? I miss Taffyta. We can see if she's home.
Sure we can, Rancis. After walking off all those 13 caramel cookies, I am going to eat 14 chocolate-covered pretzels. If the donut cops don't see me. 14 chocolate-covered pretzels. Before I eat these, I'll get the door. I hope it's not the donut cops. Well, hello, Rancis and Candlehead.
Come on inside.
Taffyta, we want to apologize for leaving you behind from the Disney Wonder Cruise.
Actually, I'm glad I didn't go on the ship, because I would not like to cruise.
You're actually happy you didn't come with us?
That's not nice to say, Taffyta. It's not because I didn't want to be with you. But I'm always afraid that the ship will rock really badly and sink underwater. Sink? Oh, come on, silly. Cruise ships are enormously huge and the Disney Wonder didn't rock or sink at all. We even avoided a storm.
Yep, we stayed in the good weather. The cruise was smooth all along.
Well, maybe one day I can give cruising a try. But I've heard of some cruise ships unexpectedly being caught in bad weather and suffering damage. Like what happened with Anthem of the Seas on the day of Super Bowl 50 in 2016 and during Hurricane Hermine in that same year.
You know, it's very rare that a cruise ship can be damaged from bad weather. They typically withstand wind, waves, and rain.
Then I suppose I can cruise one day, but I don't want to get seasick. I'm gonna have some chocolate-covered pretzels, but don't tell the cops I'm having them.
Well, the cops might actually be looking for you. They want to keep watch over you during Lent and make sure you don't eat any sugary sweets until Easter.
Well, how about this, Rancis? If you see the cops outside, just make an excuse and tell them I'm not home.
You sure it will work?
I'm totally sure.
Okay.
These chocolate-covered pretzels made my body feel tired. I want to take a rest.
You know, Candlehead, sometimes when I get what I wish for, there are actually some things about it that don't live up to my expectations.
That happens to me sometimes too, Rancis. I remember wishing for a unicorn for Christmas, but then I realized the stuffed animal unicorn is better than nothing.
Good example, Candlehead. Who's at the door?
We left her from the cruise by mistake.
Well, Taffyta is not home right now. She's out in a restaurant somewhere.
Well, if that's true, she can't be eating any sweets.
Well, she isn't. You can come back tomorrow.
Fine, we'll leave.
Well, that was a good trick I did.
Fifteen Nutter Butter Cookies. Hey there, Taffyta here.
So Taffyta, you know today's Good Friday, so this means you don't eat any meaty foods.
Oh yeah, I forgot. It's the Friday before Easter Sunday.
Easter Sunday is actually in 2 days from now, so there will be a special mass for you and your fellow racers in the arcade church at noon.
I'm not going to that mass.
Yes, you are going to that mass. It's important to honor the day of when Jesus died for our sins.
Fine, I'll go there then. It's a good thing sugary sweets are not meaty foods. I like to continue with my 1-2-3 sweets even on Good Friday. And I know I'm not allowed to bring food to church, but I don't like to just stand and listen to the priest talk about the crucifixion of Jesus Christ. I'm also still hungry. I need to eat 16 of something. But I should wait for my tummy to digest before eating something else. How about I sneak 16 Hershey Kisses into church? I'll be sure to hide them from the priest.
In the year 33 AD, Jesus Christ died for our sins on the cross. Roman authorities believed that he was inciting a political rebellion. So they condemned Jesus to being crucified. Jesus was made to bear his cross. He fell, then saw his mother. Simon also bore the cross, and Veronica wiped the face of Jesus. Then Jesus fell again, and the women of Jerusalem wept over him. After one more fall, Jesus was stripped of his garments. He was nailed to the cross, where he died for our sins. He was then taken down from the cross, and he was placed in the sepulchre. And girl in the strawberry cap, you can't bring food in the church. It's not allowed in accordance with the law.
Well, priest, I just finished my...
Talking is not allowed in here either, except for me. Now leave.
I made the priest see me eat my Hershey Kisses in church, and now I'm thrown out. Taffyta, did someone eat my caramel cookies? I did not see them when I came back to my house.
Well, I ate them.
How dare you eat my cookies?
I mean, it wasn't me who ate them.
You're definitely a liar. I know you ate them just because you're obsessed with sugary sweets.
I'm very scared right now. I reveal myself eating food in church in front of the priest, and Crumbelina knows I ate her cookies. They better not tell the donut cops I ate them, or I will be in huge trouble. And it's not even Easter yet.
That was a good mess we had, Candlehead, hearing about the 14 stations of Jesus being crucified. But why would Taffyta bring in her Hershey Kisses to church when food is not allowed in, and she didn't pay attention to what the priest said?
That's because she doesn't like to hear the story about Jesus being sentenced to the end of his life.
Well, she should have listened to the priest's words and not brought any candy with her to church, and now she's thrown out. Candlehead, you want to have pasta meatballs?
I thought we're not supposed to have meat on Good Friday.
Oh, right, we can't have meat. Maybe we'll just have the pasta.
Hey, why don't we make some brownies together?
Candlehead, why don't you leave that to me? I cook them better than you do. You keep spilling the mix.
But I like to make brownies.
Do you want to mess things up again like the last time I let you try to make hot chocolate?
Fine, Rancis, you do the food. I'm bored in my house. I don't know what sugary sweet to have 17 of. Maybe I'll just look in my closet. Well, it looks like I don't have any sugary sweets in my closet. I must have run out of sugary sweets. I'll go to Rance's house and see if he's making any brownies. He loves to make them.
Well, we must have a good meatless dinner this year on Good Friday.
I have have an aunt who never eats meat. Her name is Aunt Candle. She has been a vegetarian for over a decade.
You can start eating your dinner while I get the door. Well, come on in, Taffyta.
Rancis, have you baked any brownies today?
I actually have just finished baking them. Why, you want to have some?
I ran short of food in my house, so I came here to ask if you made any brownies.
Well, go ahead and have some. They may still be cool, and since I just took them out of the oven a few minutes ago, but they should be good by now. But don't eat all of them. Please save some for me and Candlehead.
I won't eat them all. I never eat too many brownies. 17 brownies. Delicious.
Taffyta, you are in big trouble. I told you not to eat all the brownies, and you did not listen. You made me and Candlehead upset. You gotta save some brownies for others. Now you're gonna get a stomach ache.
Well, Rancis, I am eating 1, 2, 3 sweets, going up from 1 to 20, and I only got sick after number 11. I only have 3 more numbers to go. I just finished number 17.
Oh, yeah? Well, wait till he gets sick again.
Whatever, Rancis. I'm gonna... Oh, no. My stomach hurts. I better not throw up.
Ew, you threw up on the floor.
Sorry, it was an accident.
And your left foot is on the spit food.
Rancis, I can't get my foot off the mess. I've been eating nothing but sugary sweets all Holy Week this year. I ate 1 Oreo milkshake, 2 chocolate cupcakes, 3 slices of cherry pie, 4 graham crackers, 5 doughnuts, 6 strawberry shortcakes, 7 s'mores Pop-Tarts, 8 cotton candy sticks, 9 cups of strawberry milk, 10 chocolate chip cookies, 11 Rice Krispies treats, 12 chocolate bars, 13 caramel cookies, 14 chocolate-covered pretzels, 15 Nutter Butter cookies, 16 Hershey Kisses, and 17 brownies. All I have left on my 1, 2, 3 sweets course are the numbers 18, 19, and 20, and then I will be done. Now, Doctor, can we not do the weigh thing this time? Because my body still looks perfectly fit.
Taffyta, we got to make sure you're not gaining too many pounds.
But, Doctor...
I just want to check your weight.
Doctor, aren't I supposed to take off my shoes when I step on the scale?
People say you should take off your shoes when weighing yourself, but I don't think it counts for this scale.
Well then, I suppose I can keep my shoes on.
Well, it looks like you've gone up to 100 pounds this week.
But I don't feel like it. I still feel like a great young girl head to feet.
Well, as soon as you finish your 1, 2, 3 sweets, you should cut back on sweets until you're back down to 93 pounds again. I'm gonna give you 18 gummy bears. I won't tell a doughnut police officer you're eating sweets.
I haven't had this many gummy bears in a while. 18 gummy bears. Wow, I've made it up to 18. It's unbelievable. Now I only have 2 more numbers to go, and the donut cops haven't known about and eaten 1, 2, 3 sweets yet. Looks like they'll never know about it.
Duncan, just to let you know that tomorrow will be Easter Sunday, which means Lent will be coming to an end.
I'm looking forward to celebrating tomorrow.
Please excuse this interruption, but...
My friend Taffyta ate all my brownies last night, and she did not save any for me or Candlehead. And she's stuck on 1, 2, 3 sweets in numerical order, going from 1 all the way up to 20. It's too big of a number of sweets for her to have.
Oh Jesus, we keep forgetting to keep an eye on Taffyta.
And we came back here 4 nights ago.
You wouldn't even let us come in Taffyta's house last time we tried to get in.
Well, it's about time we're setting eye on Taffyta at last.
After 8 days since last time before our cruise.
I'm almost there. I am now on number 19. I've just got this number and 20 to go. 19 yodels.
Hey, Taffyta. Are you home?
Yes, Windchill, but I'm using the bathroom now. I'll be there in a minute.
I know for a fact you're lying, Taffyta. Rancis had told us you were eating brownies last night.
I can even hear the sound of you eating. Can you please tell me exactly what you're eating right now?
Uh-oh.
Taffyta, you've got the yodel in your hand.
You're not gonna eat it, are you? And you just ate it. Are you eating sugary sweets from 1 to 20 and trying to keep this a secret from us?
We told you not to eat sugary sweets during Lent.
Well, Lent is gonna end tomorrow.
That doesn't mean you can eat sugary sweets today, Taffyta.
We want to know exactly why you're eating sugary sweets when we told you not to eat them during Lent.
Well, it's a long story.
Just tell us.
Okay, but why don't we go in the living room and I'll tell you the story.
Well, sure then.
It all started on Saturday morning on the 1st of April, 2023, when I woke up to find out that he went on the Disney Wonder cruise ship without me. So I decided to sneak on 123 Sweets without you knowing so I could get back on my obsession with sugary sweets. I never got used to my prior 37 days in a row without eating any sugary sweets because it was really hard for me. At least I still enjoy carbs and dairy foods. But getting back to my 123 Sweets course, this is exactly what I ate for the past week starting from April 1st, which is last Saturday. Last Saturday, I drank one Oreo milkshake and ate two chocolate cupcakes. On Sunday, I ate 3 slices of cherry pie and 4 graham crackers. On Monday, I ate 5 doughnuts and 6 strawberry shortcakes. On Tuesday, I ate 7 Pop-Tarts and 8 cotton candy sticks. On Wednesday, I drank 9 cups of strawberry milk and ate 10 chocolate chip cookies, 11 Rice Krispie treats, and 12 chocolate bars. On Thursday, I ate 13 caramel cookies and 14 chocolate-covered pretzels. On Friday, which was yesterday, I ate 15 Nutter Butter cookies, 16 Hershey Kisses, and 17 brownies. And now today, the current Saturday, I ate 18 gummy bears and 19 yodels. And you found me eating them. There's just one more number I haven't got to yet, which is 20. Is it okay if I finish the 123 sweets since I'm almost there?
We could easily say no, no matter what. But there is actually something different we would like to say to you.
Taffyta, we apologize for our guidance and disallowance of sugary foods for Lent. We only did that because Sour Bill forced us to do so. Sour Bill was getting sick of your sugary obsession.
But giving up something for Lent shouldn't really be 100% necessary, not even by law.
We should have never listened to Sour Bill in the first place. Also, why are you still frowning, Taffyta?
I'm not frowning, I'm happy. I'm glad you apologize for your authority. And I've just learned right now that you should never listen to someone who forcefully tries to make you give up something for Lent. Instead, it's better to choose your own thing to give up. I'd actually rather give up something important, but not very important. I may like strawberries, the fruit, but not intensely. So I should give up that for next year. I'm actually glad I stopped listening to your orders for Lent last week.
Well, we accept that as a thing from now on.
But there is one thing though, don't eat too much sugary sweets. You don't want to be sick.
I won't.
Good. We actually have a special Easter party in the castle tomorrow.
We know you'll like this one.
That sounds like lots of fun. What time should I be there by?
3 p.m.
I am definitely looking forward to tomorrow's Easter party. Should I eat my 20-something while there? I like those marshmallow lights in front of the entrance. It gives a good sugar rush feel.
Taffyta, what are you doing out there? The party's inside.
Okay, I'm coming in.
Gloyd, you must have done great setting up the party.
Yeah, Rancis, I got some delicious pizza and candy.
Are you enjoying this party?
So far, certainly I am.
I am too. I like to have that big chocolate bunny. It's tasty. Can I have it, Gloyd?
I'd rather save that for the end of the party. We're all gonna share a piece, by the way. Gloyd, do you know where Taffyta is? She seems to be running a little late for the party.
Don't worry, guys. I just got here. I managed to find 20 marshmallows from the castle kitchen.
Well, coincidentally, we're playing Now 65, and now we're up to track 16, Silence, which is a marshmallow song.
And I'm up to number 20 on my 123 Sweets course, which is 20 marshmallows. I have a question about Marshmallow the DJ. Why does the spelling of his name replace the second A with an E and omit the W at the end?
That's just how he spelled his name, Candlehead.
Would you guys like to have some lemonade or apple juice?
No, thank you, Jubilina. We're not thirsty right now. Well, we're gonna have some pizza in a bit, just to let you know. You know, Taffyta, Easter Sunday actually celebrates the resurrection of Jesus Christ when God raised him back to life from the dead.
I keep forgetting about that part. It must have been a miracle for Jesus, rising again on the third day after his crucifixion. There's actually no such thing as Jesus or God.
No, there is a such thing as Jesus and God. Get your facts right, Jubilina.
Guys, you want to have pizza now?
Yes, Gloyd. After 9 days with only sugary sweets from 1 to 20 on 123 Sweets, I can finally eat other tasty foods again, like pizza, mac and cheese,
grilled cheese, pasta, chicken tenders, and more.
There is actually some sugar in pizza, but it doesn't taste as sweet, but it's still obviously delicious.
I know, Gloyd, but I'm not gonna have 21 slices of pizza since I said I'd just go up to the number 20 on my 1-2-3 sweets. In fact, everyone wants a slice. But I think I'll have two, not much more than two.
That's fine with me. Let's all have our pizzas now. Everyone's hungry.
Okay, Gloyd.
Burgalicious definition, make them boys go crazy. They always claim they know me, coming to me, call me Stacy. I'm the F to the E, R, G, the I, the E, and can no other lady put it down like me. I'm burgalicious,
I'm delicious.
My body's stable, vicious, got me up in the gym, just working on my fitness, he's my witness. I put your boy on Rob Rob, and he be lining down the block just to watch what I got. So delicious. It's hot, hot, so delicious. I put them boys on rock, rock, so delicious. They want a slice of what I got, so delicious.
Hold, 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 hold up. Check it out.
Gather round, always looking at me up and down, looking at my. I just wanna say it now, I ain't trying to round up drama, little mama. I don't wanna take it back. And I know I'm coming off just a little bit conceited, and I keep on repeating how the boys wanna eat. But I'm trying to tell that I can't be treated like clientele, cause they say she delicious. But I ain't promiscuous, and if you were suspicious, all that is fictitious. I blow kisses. That put them boys on rock, rock, and they be lining down the block just to watch what I got.
Yo.
What a great day in Sugar Rush. What should I do today?
Rizzy, the arcade is about to open. Holy Week vacation is over.
Well, hopefully no one will beat me this time.